If I touch it, it would explode and destroy all of New York City, parts of Connecticut and New Jersey.
The Large Hadron Collider may be on the approach of discovering an actual parallel universe, or it may have already done it. But unlike science fiction, it won't mean that we wake up and Hitler has won the war. On the other hand, scientists at the Particle Collider analyze data to detect indications of other universes. Parallel universes can exist in higher dimensions just as multiple parallel sheets of paper, which are two-dimensional objects, with breadth and length, can exist in a third dimension, height. And scientists believe gravity can leak into extra dimensions, and if that happens, small black holes can be created at the Large Hadron Collider, which, according to Einstein, could be key in interdimensional travel. The first interesting and most sensible view when talking about these dimensions would be string theory. String theory is a physics theoretical framework that seeks to reconcile quantum mechanics with general relativity. It claims that the universe's fundamental building blocks are small vibrating strings of energy rather than point-like particles. One of the most exciting aspects of string theory is that it demands more than the three spatial dimensions we're familiar with: length, breadth, and height. String theory proposes that there are more spatial dimensions than the three we observe. These extra dimensions are often compacted or curled up at extremely small scales, rendering them unnoticeable in our daily lives. The number of extra dimensions necessary in string theory varies depending on the version, with some requiring up to 11 dimensions. String theory supporters believe experiments at the Large Hadron Collider could give indirect evidence for these extra dimensions. According to their theory, the LHC's high-energy particle collisions may produce energetic conditions that produce effects or signs linked with the presence of extra dimensions. These effects could be observed as deviations from particle physics standard model predictions, which currently explain known particles and their interactions. The emergence of additional particles known as Kaluza-Klein modes is one conceivable outcome of the extra dimensions anticipated by string theory. These particles would form due to the extra-dimensional string's vibrational states. Another interesting view is the quantum entanglement experiments at CERN. Quantum entanglement is a quantum physics phenomenon in which two or more particles become linked so that the state of one particle is inherently coupled to the state of another, regardless of their distance. This means that even if they are separated by large distances, measuring or manipulating one particle instantly influences the state of its entangled partner. Some believe that quantum entanglement might be utilized to transfer information instantly over long distances exceeding the speed of light. And if such information interchange was conceivable, it may enable communication or contact with parallel dimensions, assuming they exist. However, it's unknown how such communication or interaction may be produced at this time, and the fundamental boundaries of quantum entanglement are still being investigated. Also, quantum entanglement experiments have long been related to the concept of hidden variables, which are hypothetical, unseen features that impact quantum measurement outcomes. It's possible that the existence of parallel dimensions is linked to hidden variables, which influence entanglement and its repercussions. However, the nature and presence of hidden variables still remain unknown, and their relationship to parallel dimensions is largely theoretical. The existence of parallel dimensions or many worlds is proposed in various quantum physics interpretations, such as the many worlds interpretation or the many interacting worlds interpretation. These views propose that quantum entanglement is a manifestation of interactions between different parallel universes. Another reason would be in relation to black holes. At this point, you might be thinking, aren't black holes only in space? If you've watched the sci-fi show Flash, there is a moment where they turn on their particle accelerator, which later becomes unstable and creates a black hole. This is no different, as the LHC causing a black hole has been a topic occasionally debated among scientists. In theoretical physics, black holes are regions of space-time with such strong gravitational pulls that nothing, not even light, can escape. They're most commonly created by the collapse of huge stars. However, the formation and properties of black holes on extremely small scales, such as those formed in high-energy particle collisions, remain unknown and are being studied. Some theorists believe that the extreme energy and density attained during LHC collisions could potentially form miniature black holes. If these micro black holes exist, they would be far smaller and shorter-lived than astronomical black holes. If micro black holes were generated at the LHC, they might have unique qualities that allow them to access other spatial dimensions beyond the three we regularly perceive. This concept is influenced by several hypotheses, including extra-dimensional models in which gravity could become much stronger at small scales. According to these concepts, micro-black holes could serve as gates or gateways to these hidden dimensions. However, it's important to note that the development of miniature black holes at the LHC and its relation to other dimensions are still hypothetical and speculative. Creating miniature black holes necessitates energy and density levels that are beyond the LHC's capability. Furthermore, the actual development and behavior of tiny black holes and their possible connection to extra-dimensional dimensions are hot research and debate topics within the scientific community. Extensive theoretical calculations and experimental research have been conducted to study the potential production and detection of tiny black holes at the LHC. The primary goal of these investigations is to comprehend the underlying nature of high-energy particle collisions and to push the frontiers of our current understanding of physics. Another idea is quantum foam. Quantum foam is a hypothetical concept in theoretical physics that suggests space-time is chaotic and foamy at these smallest scales, rather than smooth and continuous. It's the result of the combination of quantum mechanics and general relativity, the two foundations of modern physics. At scales comparable to the Planck length, which is the lowest significant unit in physics, the structure of space-time becomes highly variable and unclear. It's envisioned as a seething sea of virtual particles that appear and disappear randomly, producing a dynamic and ever-changing landscape. The conjecture about the Large Hadron Collider and its link to hidden dimensions within the quantum foam is based on the concept that the LHC's high-energy collisions could give a window into these microscopic scales of space-time. According to some theorists, the enormous energy attained in particle collisions at the LHC may induce disruptions in the quantum foam, revealing signs or effects that could be construed as proof for the presence of other dimensions beyond those we normally see. Hidden dimensions are a prominent aspect of many theoretical frameworks, including string theory, and if they do exist, they would be compacted or curled up at such microscopic proportions that they would be invisible in our macroscopic universe. The LHC's intense circumstances, on the other hand, would have the ability to stimulate or alter these hidden dimensions, leaving visible signs in the aftermath of particle collisions. It should be noted that investigating the quantum foam and revealing hidden dimensions inside it is a very speculative and difficult task. The energy scales required to directly witness or modify the quantum foam are now beyond the capabilities of experiments, including the LHC. Furthermore, while string theory and other theoretical frameworks suggest the existence of hidden dimensions, these concepts have yet to be experimentally proven. They continue to be important fields of inquiry and theoretical exploration, with the expectation that future experimental advances may give empirical evidence to support or contradict these speculative theories. Although there is the scary part. If you travel to another dimension where things are different, only you would notice those differences. Now, if a particle did this, nobody would be aware of the differences. It would appear to us as though everything is normal. So yes, it can happen, or actually, it might have already happened. And if it has, we might never know.